Hey, what's going on, ESGN Nation, and welcome back to another episode here on NCAA Football 14, and this is the Stanford Cardinals Online Dynasty, episode 64. It's a quick little recruiting video here as we get ready to get ready for the Pac-12 Championship game, which will be coming up in the next episode. But I just want to touch base with you guys, show you guys some of the recruits that we've gotten so far here this season, and show you guys some of the players that we did not get. As you see there, Courtney Powers. Yeah, Steve beat me, and beat me pretty good in that one. We also had, there you see Clement there, try to get him, 13th ranked athlete out there. Hard-hitting Patrick Johnson from Texas there, CB there. We don't really need CBs right now, but I was just thinking an idea, like, okay, we could set him out for a year and let him develop some. But, you know, you see, we got quite a few lockouts. We had, that was actually a big issue with this, especially on the offensive line there. They just were really mean. the offensive linemen that we were going after, they just were not having it. And, of course, you know, I can understand, because Coach TJ Bonds is not well established just yet. You know, this is his only his fourth year as a head coach. He's already won now three Pac-12 championships, and of course one national championship. We're hoping to win a second one here and become back-to-back champions. That'll be a first for him. And of course I've won several back-to-back championships with his dad in past series before, but you know, it'd be nice to see if we can do that for his son here. And so far here now in this series, it's been a lot of fun putting this series together. You know, there was supposed to be a podcast that was supposed to go along with this, which we could still do. Correlate, you know, because like I said, the podcast doesn't really, it's not going to be really all about this series. It's just, it's basically going to be the idea of this podcast is that I had in my, we were talking about amongst the three of us. It's just kind of just chatting, just talking about, you know, about the NCAA game, just video games in general, really. Sports games, to be more precise. But, you know, NCAA and those type of games like this, we're going to be the kind of the heart and the soul of the podcast, which we're going to still kind of do here at some point here. I'm hoping here, some point here. We just, you know, we're all adults. You know, we all have busy schedules right now, and trying to get together and try to do stuff like that, it's a little tough. So but there you see some of the players that we are looking at right now, and like I said, there's some players here that, you know, they're not going to be the starters right off the bat. They're like Ronnie Givens, Givens there, 80, you know, quarterback, three-star guy. We're going to go after him, but he's basically there for depth. He'll probably be redshirted next season to kind of just get the experience, you know, just holding a clipboard and just kind of seeing what he can do. Really right there, as you see, not really impressive numbers. I'm not really getting too excited. You know, I think we got quite a few athletes. I think I showed in the first recruitment video. We got some pretty good athletes that I think that are going to be really nice for us next season. If not next season, then a season from now. It's just going to take some time to working with them, and of course they have to learn the schemes and the verbiage and all that kind of stuff, and just kind of understand what Coach TJ Bonds is asking for. You know, Coach TJ Bonds is pretty, he's a pretty intense guy. You know, his dad is kind of, you know, more of a player's coach. You know, he's been there before. You know, he's, you know, you don't want to get on his bad side because he will snap your head off real quick if you do that. But Coach TJ Bonds is, I mean, if you're not doing, if you know, we've seen him already kind of bench and replace QBs already in a midseason, especially in the middle of a game, like, oh, no, you're done, putting him in. So he's the kind of guy, he just, you know, he's kind of knee-jerk reaction. He wears his emotions on his sleeve, and, you know, you hate him for that. Hey, whatever, he'll move on to the next thing. But so far, like I said, this has been a fun series to put together, and of course we have one more season we're gonna play here, season 5, And then we're going to kind of take a break from this series, and we're going to bring a new NCAA series in, and I'm kind of working on that. Literally as we speak right now, I've been on my computer, or my other computer over here, I'm kind of working on some stuff for it. It's going to be a coaching carousel with a new head coach, and I got a fun story that I've been putting together for that and everything. It actually coincides with another series that we have here on the channel already, and that is the Miles Marvel series. So definitely check it out. It's on the main channel. I'll leave a link in the eye up here above, and leave a link down and below in the description here of this video. But if you don't know about that series, definitely go check it out. It's a fun series. We're halfway through the first year in college. So definitely check it out. It's gonna be it's a lot of fun. Newer episodes are coming out here sometime before the end of August. I'm working on those also too here. But yeah, so we take a look here, just looking at some of these players that we're looking at, or that we're trying to go after here right now, the final week or so of the regular season. And there you see, oh, nice gym there, 70 overall. Derek Fraser, he's a defensive end. And look at his tackle and his hit power, his pursuit, and just right there, play recognition, perfect for him. 70 overall player. We're hoping that we can get him to sign that. We already offered, we offered him a scholarship, and we're just hoping that we can lock him down here. Brian Boyd, outside linebacker, he's 105th in the nation, 5-star. Steve was looking at him too, but we got a lead right now, and I think with a decent victory, if we can win this game against USC, I think he might actually go ahead and sign, and we'll have him officially on the team. But right now he is still not necessarily on the fence, but I think we're pulling him in slowly, and we're hoping that we can hook him and then drag him in. So we're hoping that that'll be the case. And you see Taylor, he's way down there, but he's not, and we're above his cutoff, his lockout points, so he's pretty much locked in for us. We just got to try to sign, seal, and deliver that. Yeah, I know a lot of people joke about it. It's like, okay, let's give him that big old bag, that big old McDonald's bag full of some money, But we don't do that in this program. We don't do that, not yet. but maybe in the future, I don't know. Especially with the way NCAA is right now. Jeez, it's gonna be a madhouse. Jeez, anyway. Let's get into some guards here. We got Andrew Daniels, another guard here. And a lot of these guys here, you see 60, mid-60s or upper 60s, stuff like that. They're just guys that we're trying to bring in for some depth. And they probably won't hit the field the first year unless something drastically changes there. But you see Daniels there. We're just outside of this cutoff point there. We're hoping that this week, again, like I said, play against USC and play in that national, or play in that Pac-12 game there, we can reel some of these guys in here and hopefully change their minds about Stanford. Stanford is a school. I mean, it's a tough school to go to. You have to have the brains to go to it and survive it. It's one of those nice West Coast I don't say it's an Ivy League school, but it's a good school. You gotta have that GPA and that those certain numbers on a SAT or SAT or ACT to get in there. Joseph, there you see from Midland, Texas, 3-star guys. Taylor's looking at him, and been fighting with him. This has been the fun thing about this series, is playing against two other users and trying to, make it. It's been difficult. You don't get everybody you want because you can cheese it. And that's what I do at least in my Highland Sky series. I don't cheese I know I can get basically anybody I want it if I do certain things, but I don't want to cheese it. I want to make it difficult as possible, and it's supposed to be difficult because you're not gonna get everybody you want on your team. because if you did, it'd be impossible putting all those players on the team. So that's why I like how Steve has the settings set up here. He has the settings pretty similar to what I had, because I kind of told him, like, hey, you know, let's kind of, you know, why don't you guys do it like this? And he's like, yeah, you know, it's not a bad idea. And that's they had something similar to what I had when I got into this series with them. But yeah, it's really fun. I still say, like, I see a lot of people playing, you know, 10, 12, and 13, you know, 10, 11, and 12 of NCAA. And those were good NCAA, especially when it came to recruiting. That was fun when you called them. You know, you had, you know, you had an hour max of when you could talk to them. You could talk to them about anything you want. I'm hoping and praying that in the next NCAA game that's coming out, a year from now or 2 years from now, I'm hoping that they'll bring that type of recruiting back. None of this recruiting here, because this recruiting here is, sometimes it can be too cheesy, and then sometimes it can be just too difficult. So I'm hoping they'll bring back the calling, because the calling was fun. I'm hoping they'll bring back a lot of different things in the NCAA games. For the next NCAA college football game in the future, because there's a lot of good features I've been, because I've actually brought some couple of those older games for my PS3 and my PS2, and it's been a lot of fun going back and playing those and checking those out and see how they're, you know, how they work out and stuff, and look, you know, the recruiting on there was, they were fun, especially in 10. But I know you see Nate Palmer, 78. This guy we've been going after all season long here. And at the last minute there, he decided to go with the Lovely Lions there. So there you see great speed. And then some other good, but he's committed. So, yeah, we were trying our best there. We had him, he showed up in week 5. I thought maybe, I'm like, okay, he's going to show up in week 5. We got him. We were in his top of his list there for a couple weeks straight, and then we just, for whatever reason, I don't know if Steve got him some hookers or what, but we've definitely, like, he's like, nope, not going here no more, do not want to go to Stanford. All right, so you see the other team guys that we've picked up here, some other prospects that we picked up through the course of the start of the season, of course, up to just recently here. And I think we got a pretty good squad there. We got a lot of 70-plus overall players that are going to be very impressive for us. And they're going to do very well for us next season. Vince Adams, I'm really excited about. He has some really good – looks like he's going to be a really good – could be a decent quarterback for us next season if I think that's one that he had a good throw power there and whatnot. Take a look at our top classes there. And, of course, we had 10. So far, we have 10 recruits. 7 of those are 4-star. 3 of them are 3-star. We'll take a look here at some others. I believe Taylor and Steve probably are at the top of that list. I know Taylor has at least 1 5-star. He might have 2 5-stars. 3 5-stars. Okay, he has 8 4-stars. Steve has 8 4-stars. Steve has 1 5-star. Steve has a lot of 10 3-stars and 1 2-star. And Taylor has 5 3-star athletes there. So those guys, of course, you know, their coaches are well established. They are, you know, they've won several national championships or bowl games. So, you know, they know what they're pretty solid. They're pretty established there. And of course we can't really compare ourselves to that, 'cause we're, you know, this is just our 4th year, but, of course, so you see Clemson with 24 total, signees there for their squad for next season. Taylor has 16 and I believe Steve had 20. So both guys are doing very well here. In this series, of course, and it's gonna be a lot of fun because, like I said, you know, I got my Pac-12 championship game against USC. Taylor has a game against TCU, for the Big Ten, and Steve does not have a conference championship game, so his is automatic bid. So if one of us two happens to lose, because Taylor, I believe, is 3, Steve is 4, I'm 1, and Texas A&M is number 2. You know, if two of us fall, the top two teams fall, then, of course, Taylor and Steve will be in that national championship thing. Or if Texas A&M happens to lose, Taylor will get bumped up, and Steve will get bumped up, and A&M, of course, will fall. Yeah, but, you know, there could be, I mean, weirder things have happened if you guys have, been, you know, play NCAA yourselves. You know, you could be at number one, and all of a sudden, based on your schedule, how well you did with your schedule and how well the other guys did in their schedule, you could be number one and be easily dropped out of number one real quick just by, you know, you didn't score enough points. I've had that happen to me more than enough, more than I want to explain. But there you see the championship conference week there. You see us. That game will, of course, be in San Diego. TCU, Air Force, I believe that will be in Air Force. I think they have the better record. They host that game. Georgia and Texas A&M, of course, playing in Atlanta for the SEC championship. Texas A&M has just been on murder row when it comes to facing opponents, and this one's gonna be a tough one for them against Georgia. That Georgia team is a tough team. Miami taking on Florida State for the ACC championship. That one's gonna be a good one. An all Florida championship game there for that one. And of course, Miami University, Miami of Ohio, taking on Ball State in the I believe that's the MAC championship game. So, but yeah, got a lot of good championship games on this tap here. And like I said, the one we got to worry about is ours. Of course, we also going to be kind of poking in and seeing kind of occasionally. I'm hoping they'll have it on this. Hopefully their games play before ours. Hopefully it'll be on the ticker there on the bottom of the screen when I play my game, so I'll know who I'm going to be facing in the national championship game. If we get a chance to play in the national championship game, I got to worry about, like, okay, you got to win to get in. So, as for bowl predictions, it looks like Steve's going to go to the Rose Bowl, possibly with Georgia. It looks like if everything plays out like it's supposed to, based off, you know, just because number one, number two playing against each other for the national championship. And then Fiesta Bowl for Taylor, and that'll be against USC. So, wow. Yeah, the top teams that have been playing each other this week could be facing each other, you know, a different combination next week or in the next couple weeks here as they get ready for the Pro Bowl. Or, geez. The NCAA bowl games. And, of course, you see Texas A&M. We're the home team if we happen to play in that game for the BCS championship game. And that'll be number 2, Texas A&M, 12-0 right now. In the conference against us. And looks like we're the, looks like in the, at least in the Pac-12 game, we are the favorites in this one. And, of course, USC, we have not played them. I want to say since the second season. I might be wrong. It's just been so long since we've... it hasn't been that long because I started this series back earlier this year. But, yeah, it's been a while since we've seen USC, and hopefully we can play well against it. Now, USC lost in overtime against Notre Dame. 14th-ranked Notre Dame there, you see. 31-28. And then they turn around and won against Arizona the following week in another another game in overtime. This time they won that one 40-37. So USC, as you see there, time to do or die. And we're hoping to do our best and kill off USC and try to get that national championship in our in our midst. Hopefully, we can, I don't know. I hate to say that we're going to go in there and just whip them. But, if we can go in there and get hot real quick and really take over that first, that first half there, then we have a shot. But if it's going to be what I think it's going to be, top six teams in there, it's going to be a dogfight. It's going to be basically whoever has possession of the ball last. We'll get crack at the, and then also too, USC can be making a run for the national championship in this one. So a lot of crazy things can happen if we don't get our act together. So we have to worry about ourselves. Of course, like I said, I will be watching the ticker there because I want to make sure. I want to see if A&M continue to run the table there in the SEC. But that's it for this episode, you guys, of the Stanford Cardinals Online Dynasty, episode 64. Just a quick look at the recruiting there, you guys. And so far, I think we have a decent recruiting class. Not the best recruiting class I would say, but probably a decent recruiting class that can help us out in some lot of areas that we need some depth in. So, but that's it for me. As always, if you guys enjoyed the video, please leave a like. That helps me out a lot. Hit that bell notification so you guys be notified of this series or any other series here on the channel. Hit that subscribe button if you happen to be new. Don't forget to check us out on Facebook or Twitter and Discord, as we do have those down below in the description. Check out our Discord because there's some really good stuff on there you guys can check out. Also, promote your own channel. There's a promote yourself tab or I don't know, I forgot what it's called, but if you got socials or anything like that, drop them down in that section in Discord. I love to check out other people's channels and just see what everybody else is doing when it comes to sports content, sports video game content on YouTube. So big fan of it. I really enjoy it. And if you got your own, let me know down there in Discord. And definitely check it out. I just want to try to build a community over there and just have some fun and stuff like that. So also too, we do have a Highland Scotties team builder series here on the channel that you guys definitely should go check out. It's a good series there. I'll leave a link. It should be a link down below in the description also. And I'll leave a link in the eye there also so you guys can check that out series, because that's Coach TJ Bond's dad who coaches the Highland Scotties series there on the main channel. But that's it for me. As always, keep yourselves and each other healthy, and I will see you guys next time.